If you like this video, why not subscribe? Hey, it's the $1 Budget, the show where we take this and spend it on filmmaking stuff. These are things that have accumulated over the past month for me, and I want to share them with you. All right, this is a SanDisk Cruiser Switch USB flash drive. I found these at Walmart. They were about $5, and I realized it's a little over a dollar, but look how much memory you get here, 8 gigabytes, which means you can move a lot of video around with this from computer to computer. Can't put these in a camera, obviously, because they're a USB stick instead of a SD card or a CF card, but handy nonetheless. Now these are about $5, but they're typically not marked, at least the ones I found in Walmart. So we go to the price scanner and scan them, and it'll be $5. If you want to spend $2.50 more, like I did on this one, you can get 16 gigabytes for $7.50. Again, check the price scanner to make sure you're getting the right price. What's the drawback of these? And so you might say, well, there can't be a drawback. That's an awesome price. They're SanDisk, good brand. However, when you open them up, you'll notice that the connector is all plastic. There is no metal on the outside of this. All the guts are in there. I'm sure there's some metal inside the little circuit board, and then it rotates around, clicks together kind of nicely. I like the little keychain thing here, and so far it's been pretty good, but of course if you step on this or abuse it in any way, it's probably going to crack or break, and you might not be able to insert it into your computer anymore. So just be aware of that. But still, for $5, 8 gigabytes, 750, 16 gigabytes, that's kind of a no-brainer in my opinion. Just be careful. Okay, next up, we've got these USB to wall outlet adapters. If you need to run anything with a USB, a 5-volt USB, I believe it is, you can plug these into the wall. These are clones of the iPhone connector, iPhone adapter that you get with your iPhone. They look exactly alike, I've noticed, but I wanted to get one off of eBay because they were a dollar on eBay, but I wanted to make sure they worked before I even recommended them to anybody. What would you use something like this for in filmmaking besides to charge your phone, which is important? Well, I've mentioned these, you know, flexible gooseneck LED lights before, and how you can power them with these connectors. And I think I used my old Palm connector in that $1 budget video I did last time where I featured these, but these work just as well. I want to experiment more with these, with some car lighting or, you know, micro lighting, things like that. Special effects lighting, it'd be cool if you had these, you know, like in the palm of your hand or something for some sort of effect on the person's face. Hold this in your hand, point the light at their face for a kind of a sci-fi type thing. But now you can power these easily without having to scavenge this from your cell phone. So now you can just go to eBay and get them. Check the link below to find out where you do that. All right, I found these at Walmart recently as I've been looking into some sort of a CFL kind of soft light setup, and I was surprised to find these at Walmart for 97 cents. It's a pretty good deal. And it's just a socket, any standard light socket you want to plug an incandescent bulb into or a CFL bulb that plugs right into a wall outlet or a power strip or whatever sort of DIY gadget you're working on. This would be a good building block for that. I'll probably be using these in the near future, but I wanted to share this with anybody in case you're looking for these and wanted to save a little money on the hardware store price, which I believe is around $1.52. So Walmart, 97 cents, check it out. And finally, we have this suggestion, a great suggestion from a viewer, Jared McGuire. He told me to go to Dollar Tree and look for the gum soft picks where you get 10 picks in a package. If you want to pick your teeth of all that nasty food that gets trapped in there. And he said, hey, there's a little case that comes with it that is ideal to store 4 SD cards. So I went to Dollar Tree and I picked one of these up because I thought that was a great tip for a dollar. And let's test out Jared's theory here. We got your picks. I can pick my teeth later with those. Now we have this plastic case where it says gum on the outside, an awesome place to store cards. So I've got a bunch of SD cards here. Let's see how many will fit into this tiny little case. We have 1, we have 2, 3, and 4. And sure enough, Jared is correct. You can fit 4 SD cards in these and in this, and it only costs a dollar. That's pretty good. Let's see if we can max it out here. We've got 6 SD cards. Of course, they're just barely floating on the top here, so maybe this isn't the best idea, because when you open it, they would explode everywhere. Oh my gosh, it fits. 6 SD cards will fit inside of this. And of course, you notice it's now bulging on the sides. Maybe that's not such a good idea. Although actually, you know, even if you're just putting 2 SD cards in here, where they, when you open it up, they don't fall off the slide off the top. It's still a good idea if you want an easy way to transport your cards. Of course, now they slide around the case, but I say we go with Jared's suggestion. Good suggestion. 4 SD cards. They're easily stored in the gum. Oh, sticking out the side. The gum soft picks. Soft picks from gum. The gum soft picks SD card holder. Only $1. All right, well, that's everything we have this week. Hopefully you learned about some cool stuff that you can get that might help you make your next movie. And all you're going to be spending is $1, or maybe a little more for this. See ya.